Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're going to solve lead code number 984, string without AAA or BBB. So you can read the problem statement yourself, it's pretty straightforward. But what I wanted to show you here is a pattern that I believe can be really useful in a lot of different problems. So to solve this problem, we're going to make an assumption that is actually not true and makes the problem really much easier. And then we're going to solve the fact that that assumption is actually wrong. Okay, so the assumption that we're going to make is that the amount of A characters that we need to put in our result is larger than the amount of B's. So that's not true, but we're going to assume that it is. And you can think, if this problem said, okay, you have more A characters than B characters, it would be really easy, right? Because you just keep putting A's and interval them with B's when needed, and then you return the result. So that's what we're going to do here. We're going to pretend that we know that the amount of A characters is larger than the amount of B characters. So the online judge actually lets me return an array. It doesn't want me to return a string. So yeah, I'm going to do that, save a bit of time. So then I'm going to store in two variables the letters that the problem wants me to put in the result, which are A and B. And then we're going to solve the problem with a while loop. So this is just a shorthand because the first thing that we're going to do in our while loop is push an A character in our result. And so, yeah, I already decrement the amount of A characters that we still need to push by one, because I know that the next thing I'm going to do is push an A character in the result. But you could not do the minus minus here and do it here instead. It doesn't really matter. It doesn't make any difference. Okay, so remember that we can do this. Why can we go? Can we use this as the condition for our while loop? It's because we know that A is greater than B, okay? So now we check if A is still greater than B, even after decrementing it. And if it is, then we need to push another A, so that we're going to make them equal sooner or later. Because for every while loop here, we push an A character two times, if A is still greater than B. And so we decrement A once, and we need to also decrement A here. So A is going down by two, if A is still greater than B. And now we're just going to, you know, every two A's, we need to put one B, or we're going to break this rule. So yeah, that's what we do. If we still have B characters, push the B character in the result. And we know that here it tells us that it is guaranteed that such a string exists for the given A and B. So we don't need to worry about this maybe causing some error and causing three A's to appear. Okay. So this would be the result already for the problem where we know that A is larger than B. Now we need to solve, what if A is actually not greater than B? Well, in that case, we're going to solve it here. So if B is greater than A, then what we do is we swap the characters. So the character that before was A now becomes B, and the character that before was B becomes A, and also the two counts swap. So A is now B, and B is now A. And that solves our problem, and it's basically forcing the constraints that I was making up before by swapping around the variables, so that now, after this condition, it's true that A is larger than B, because we've swapped them around if that wasn't the case. So this is always going to be true. So I mean, our assumption is always going to be true. So I'm going to submit this, and this algorithm is optimal. It is an O of N, where n is a plus b, time complexity and space complexity. And obviously you can't do any better because you literally need to output a string with a plus b characters. So you can't do any better than O of n memory, where n is the sum of a and b. So that's it for today, and bye.